Good evening students, welcome to 11th standard chemistry video class. We are discussing the lesson basic concepts of chemistry and chemical calculations. In our last video class, we completed two important topics, namely limiting reagents and redox reactions. In this redox reactions, oxidation and reduction reactions are explained on the basis of oxygen, hydrogen and electronic concept. In this video, we will discuss the definition for oxidation number, rules for assigning oxidation number and calculation of oxidation number. First, let me discuss the definition for oxidation number. The oxidation number or otherwise called oxidation state. Oxidation number. Here we are having the definition for oxidation number. It is given in your chemistry volume 1 book, page number 20. Oxidation number is defined as the imaginary charge left on the atom when all other atoms of the compound have been removed in their usual oxidation states that are assigned according to set of rules. Again, I repeat, oxidation number is defined as the imaginary charge left on the atom when all other atoms of the compound have been removed in their usual oxidation states that are assigned according to set of rules. Or otherwise, oxidation number is the number that is allocated to elements in a chemical combination. The oxidation number is basically the count of electrons that atom in a molecule can share, lose or gain while forming chemical bonds with other atoms of a different element. Again, I repeat, oxidation number is the number that is allocated to elements in a chemical combination. The oxidation number is basically the count of electrons that atom in a molecule can share, lose or gain while forming chemical bonds with other atoms of a different element. The oxidation number is otherwise called oxidation state. Next one, rules for writing or assigning oxidation number. We are having 7 points. Let me discuss one by one. Rules for assigning oxidation number. First point, the oxidation state of a free element is zero. The oxidation state of a free element, that is in its uncombined state, is zero. For example, each atom in H2, Cl2, Na, S8 have the oxidation number of zero. Again, I repeat, the oxidation state of a free element, that is in its uncombined state, is zero. Second point, for a monoatomic ion, the oxidation state is equal to the net charge on the ion. What is called monoatomic ion? A single atom with positive charge or negative charge is said to be monoatomic ion. Hence, for a monoatomic ion, the oxidation state is equal to total charge of the ion. For example, the oxidation number of sodium in Na plus ion is plus 1. In Na plus ion, the oxidation number of sodium is plus 1. Since sodium with the symbol Na, it contains the charge plus, which means plus 1. Hence, the oxidation number of sodium in sodium ion is plus 1. Similarly, the oxidation number of chlorine in Cl- is minus 1. In Cl minus ion, the oxidation number of chlorine is minus 1. Since chlorine with the symbol Cl, it contains the charge minus, which means minus 1. Hence, the oxidation number of chlorine in chloride ion is minus 1. It is given in the second point. Third point, the algebraic sum of oxidation states of all atoms in a molecule is equal to 0. While in ions, it is equal to the net charge on the ion. Here, we are having two options. One is molecule, next one is ion. If you consider molecule, the algebraic sum of oxidation state of all atoms in a molecule is equal to 0. You have to add all the oxidation number of atoms in a molecule, which is equal to 0. If you consider ion, it may be positive ion or negative ion. The algebraic sum of oxidation state of all atoms in an ion is equal to net charge on the ion. It may equal to positive value or negative value based upon the ion. Here we are having two examples, one for molecule, next one for ion. For example, H2SO4, it is sulfuric acid. It is a molecule. Here, the sum of oxidation state of all atoms in H2SO4 is equal to 0. It is given by 2 into oxidation number of hydrogen plus 1 into oxidation number of sulfur plus 4 into oxidation number of oxygen, which is equal to 0. In the above form, 2 into oxidation number of hydrogen, the number 2 represents number of hydrogen atom. Hence, we are having 2 hydrogen atom in H2SO4. Next one, 1 into oxidation number of sulfur. The number 1 represents number of sulfur atom. Hence, we are having 1 sulfur atom in H2SO4. Finally, 4 into oxidation number of oxygen. The number 4 represents number of oxygen atom. Hence, we are having 4 oxygen atom in H2SO4. Next example, SO4 2-, which is sulfate ion. It is an example for ion. The sum of oxidation state of all atom in SO4 2- is equal to minus 2. It is given by 1 into oxidation number of sulfur plus 4 into oxidation number of oxygen, which is equal to minus 2. Since the net charge of sulfate ion is minus 2, or otherwise, in SO4 2- ion, the net charge is equal to minus 2. In the above form, 1 into oxidation number of sulfur, the number 1 represents number of sulfur atom. Hence, we are having 1 sulfur atom in SO4 2- ion. Next one, 4 into oxidation number of oxygen, the number 4 represents number of oxygen atom. Hence, we are having 4 oxygen atom in SO4 2- ion. Hence, we completed third point. Fourth point, hydrogen has an oxidation number of plus 1 in all its compounds except in metal hydrides, where it has minus 1 value. Again, I repeat, hydrogen has an oxidation number of plus 1 in all its compounds except in metal hydrides. For metal hydrides, it has minus 1 value. It is explained with an example. Here, oxidation number of hydrogen in hydrogen chloride is plus 1. Hydrogen chloride with the formula HCl. Oxidation number of hydrogen in sodium hydride is minus 1. The sodium hydride with the formula NaH. How we are getting the value plus 1 and minus 1 that we will discuss in our calculation part. Hence, we completed fourth point. Fifth point, fluorine has an oxidation state of minus 1 in all its compounds. Fluorine is an example for halogen. The oxidation number of fluorine is minus 1 in all its compounds. Hence, we completed fifth point. Sixth point, the oxidation state of oxygen in most compounds is minus 2. Exceptions are peroxides, superoxides, and compounds with fluorine. Here, we are having some example. The oxidation number of oxygen in water is minus 2. The water with the formula H2O. The next one, the oxidation number of oxygen in hydrogen peroxide is minus 1. The hydrogen peroxide with the formula H2O2. How to calculate the oxidation number of oxygen in hydrogen peroxide is given here. 2 into plus 1 plus 2x, which is equal to 0. Here, 2 into plus 1. The 2 represents number of hydrogen atom, where the plus 1 represents the oxidation number of hydrogen atom. The next one, 2x. The 2 represents number of oxygen atom, where the x represents the oxidation number of oxygen atom. The atom for which we have to calculate the oxidation number must be taken as x, or the unknown value must be taken as x. Therefore, 2 into plus 1 plus 2x, which is equal to 0. 2x equal to minus 2. Finally, we will get x equal to minus 1. Hence, the oxidation number of oxygen in hydrogen peroxide is minus 1. The next one, the oxidation number of oxygen in superoxides such as KO2 is minus 1 by 2. Here, plus 1 plus 2x, which is equal to 0. Here, the plus 1 represents the oxidation number of potassium atom. It is given with the symbol K. The next one, 2x. The 2 represents the number of oxygen atom, where the x represents the oxidation number of oxygen atom. Therefore, plus 1 plus 2x, which is equal to 0, we will get 2x is equal to minus 1. Finally, x equal to minus 1 by 2. Therefore, the oxidation number of oxygen in superoxides such as KO2 is minus 1 by 2. Finally, oxidation number of oxygen in oxygen difluoride is plus 2. The oxygen difluoride with the formula OF2. X plus 2 into minus 1, which is equal to 0. Here, the X represents the oxidation number of oxygen atom. The 2 into minus 1, the 2 represents number of fluorine atom. The minus 1 represents the oxidation number of fluorine atom. Therefore, X plus 2 into minus 1, which is equal to 0, X equal to plus 2. So, the oxidation number of oxygen in oxygen difluoride is plus 2. Hence, we completed sixth point. Seventh point, alkali metals have an oxidation state of plus 1 and alkaline earth metals have an oxidation state of plus 2 in all their compounds. Again, I repeat, alkali metals have an oxidation state of plus 1 and alkaline earth metals have an oxidation state of plus 2 in all their compounds. Hence, we completed the rules for assigning oxidation number. Next topic, calculation of oxidation number using the above rules. In this tabular column, we are having the calculation of oxidation number using the above said rules. Here, we are having 5 examples. Let us discuss one by one. This tabular column contains serial number, oxidation number of the element in the compound and calculation. Let me start with the first example. In the compound CO2, we have to calculate the oxidation number of carbon with the symbol C. It is given in the calculation part. X plus 2 into minus 2, which is equal to 0. Here, the X represents the oxidation number of carbon because the atom for which we have to calculate the oxidation number must be taken as X. 2 into minus 2. Here, the 2 represents number of oxygen atom, minus 2 represents the oxidation number of oxygen atom. Therefore, X plus 2 into minus 2, which is equal to 0. Finally, X is equal to plus 4. Therefore, the oxidation number of carbon in carbon dioxide is plus 4. Next example, H2SO4. In the compound H2SO4, we have to calculate the oxidation number of sulfur with the symbol S. It is given in the calculation part. 2 into plus 1 plus X plus 4 into minus 2, which is equal to 0. Here, 2 into plus 1. The 2 represents number of hydrogen atom. The plus 1 represents the oxidation number of hydrogen. The X represents the oxidation number of sulfur. Since the atom for which we have to calculate the oxidation number must be taken as X. 4 into minus 2. The 4 represents number of oxygen atom. Minus 2 represents the oxidation number of oxygen atom. Therefore, 2 into plus 1 plus X plus 4 into minus 2, which is equal to 0. 2 plus X minus 8, which is equal to 0. After simplification, we will get X equal to plus 6. Therefore, the oxidation number of sulfur in H2SO4 is plus 6. Next example, Cr2O7 2-. In this Cr2O7 2-, we have to calculate the oxidation number of chromium with the symbol Cr. It is given in the calculation part. 2x plus 7 into minus 2, which is equal to minus 2. Here, in the 2x, the 2 represents number of chromium atom. The x represents the oxidation number of chromium. 7 into minus 2. The 7 represents number of oxygen atom. The minus 2 represents the oxidation number of oxygen, which is equal to minus 2. Why we are using minus 2? Here, we are taking the example ion. Here, if you are using the ion means, the algebraic sum of the oxygen state of all atoms in an ion is equal to net charge on the ion. So here, the ion with the charge minus 2, hence it is equated to minus 2. Therefore, 2x minus 14, which is equal to minus 2, x equal to plus 6. Therefore, the oxidation number of chromium in Cr2O7 2- is plus 6. Next compound, CH2F2. In this compound CH2F2, we have to calculate the oxidation number of carbon with the symbol C. It is given in the calculation part. X plus 2 into plus 1 plus 2 into minus 1, which is equal to 0. Here, X represents the oxidation number of carbon, 2 into plus 1. The 2 represents number of hydrogen atom. The plus 1 represents oxidation number of hydrogen. 2 into minus 1. The 2 represents number of fluorine atom. The minus 1 represents the oxidation number of fluorine. Therefore, x plus 2 into plus 1 plus 2 into minus 1, which is equal to 0. After simplification, we will get x equal to 0. Therefore, the oxidation number of carbon in CH2F2 is 0. Next compound, SO2. In this compound SO2, we have to calculate the oxidation number of sulfur with the symbol S. It is given in the calculation part. X plus 2 into minus 2, which is equal to 0. Here, the X represents the oxidation number of sulfur, 2 into minus 2. The 2 represent number of oxygen atom. The minus 2 represents the oxidation number of oxygen. Therefore, X plus 2 into minus 2, which is equal to 0. Therefore, X equal to plus 4. The oxidation number of sulfur in SO2 is plus 4. Hence, we completed the calculation of oxidation number using above said rules. In this video, we completed the definition for oxidation number, the rules for assigning oxidation number, and the calculation of oxidation number. This topic is present in your Chemistry Volume 1 book, page number 20 and 21. Let me stop up to this topic. The remaining topic that we will discuss in our next video class. Thank you.